We are the body of Christ. I think of the body of Christ as like an actual body. Whereas if one arm is missing, it cannot be completely functioning without that one arm. We need the body to work together. We need every muscle and arm and leg and toe and ligament and everything. We need everything. I encourage you all today to stay close with the body of Christ. We need each other. Talk to each other. Talk to the body of Christ. Talk to the church every single day. And if you can't, you know, at least once a week. We were not meant to be alone. Genesis 2:18, it is not good that the man should be alone. Proverbs 18:1, whoever isolates himself seeks his own desire. He breaks out against all sound judgment. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, 9 to 10. Two are better than one because they have a good reward for their toil. For if they fall, one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him who is alone when he falls and has not another to lift him up. I'm going to read 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 12 to 27. One body with many members. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in one spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and all were made to drink of one spirit. For the body does not consist of one member, but of many. If the foot should say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. And if the ear should say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would be the sense of hearing? If the whole body were an ear, where would be the sense of smell? But as it is, God arranged the members in the body, each one of them as he chose. If all were a single member, where would the body be? As it is, there are many parts, yet one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you, nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. On the contrary, the parts of the body that seem to be weaker are indispensable, and on those parts of the body that we think less honorable, we bestow the greater honor, and our unpresentable parts are treated with greater modesty, which our more presentable parts do not require, but God has so composed the body, giving greater honor to the part that lacked it, that there may be no division in the body, but that the members may have the same care for one another. If one member suffers, all suffer together. If one member is honored, all rejoice together. Now you are the body of Christ and individually members of it. We are one body. Let's act like it and stay together because we need every part of the body to function and work right. God bless.